Artist Toolkit
with Guitar Guitar.
Hey everyone, Jared James Nichols here, and I'm so excited to be at Guitar Guitar Camden, and this is my Artist Toolkit. So the biggest thing for me as a player is my hands. Figuring out how I'm going to play, how I am going to use my hands to get out the sound that's in my heart, get out the sound that's in my head. So the first thing is, everyone should know that I play with my fingers. So I know that's a little crazy, a little weird, but it's something that I do because I'm a lefty. I write with my left hand, I eat with my left hand, I drink with it. So when I picked up a guitar, it never felt quite right for me to use a pick. I love the feeling of the strings underneath my fingers. Now, there's a lot of guitar players that play electric and acoustic fingerstyle. I have a little bit more of an aggressive approach to the guitar. There's a lot of things that I do that maybe aren't gentle, but using my fingers, it gives me a different tone, a different feel, and overall, yet again, it's all about what I can get out with my hands. So if I play the guitar and I go crazy on it, or I can go nice and easy. There's so many different sounds that I can get out just by how I attack the guitar. So that's the big thing I'd like to talk about. With my style, my thumb is always going down on the strings. My index, my middle, and my ring are always coming up. Now, I can do more of a proper downstroke with my thumb. Snap it up. With my index, I can pull up on the string, which is I'm pulling up towards my body, right? I can snap it up towards the sky. So there's a lot of different things that you can do, even if you don't use your fingers. Use your pick, and you can adjust how you pick into the string to give you a different sound. Also, where you're picking on the string is a huge, huge aspect of it. So if I'm playing down here, it gets more bassy as I go towards the neck. And that's something that I really rely on when I'm playing. So if I'm playing a run, let's say I play, now my hand will be straight in between both pickups, and I'll go like this, like a. Or I can do it back. Closer to the. Now the adjusting, the how much I'm actually pushing into the strings as well. Backing off. All of these things really can be accounted for, and it's a note by note procedure. So as you're playing the guitar, you could play a lick 15 different ways just by adjusting how you're picking, where you're picking. The tone really relies in you just sitting and really getting comfortable with that. Think of yourself almost as someone who plays like a horn. You know, it's all about your breath support. So as a guitar player, we can, you know, we can turn all the way up and we can. Or we can approach the guitar more like a horn player wouldn't have to go. Using dynamics. There's a lot of things you can do just by adjusting how much you're picking into the string and how you're snapping on it. And that's another thing I'd like to say is I'm also always thinking about the tension of the strings, because obviously each string has a different tension. Really think about that and hold yourself accountable to that, because it's very important as a player to be one with the strings. When I'm bending, when I'm picking into it, I need to know how much I need to attack it. So with a bend, A lot of players tend to bend on our high E string, which is great, right? Our B string, the G string, but I like to go down on the wound strings as well, so the D, A, and E string, right? So don't be afraid to bend those strings and learn the tension and learn how much pressure you need in your hands to really pull that off. So for instance, bending on these low strings, check this out. On the D string. There's a lot of cool things you can get out of really squeezing as much as you can out of each string. So that's one of the big things for me too, talking about this, is obviously working your volume and tone controls on your guitar. Whether you play a Les Paul, a Strat, whatever, it's so important to really utilize your volume and tones because there's so much that lies in there. As you can see, I'm always messing around with it. So from a whisper to a scream, I could play a lick like this, like a... Bring it up a little bit. Very important because you can adjust so much without using a pedal, without even looking at your amplifier, just with the tones on your guitar. Even so, you can get more of a rolling down that tone knob. You can get the... And then messing around with both of them, you can have your volume down, your tone down, and you start to get really... So many sounds at your fingertips that I think a lot of guitar players, even if you have a ton of pedals, everything, the more you get in tune with your guitar, through your hands, the better. It will lend you to being more creative on the fly without thinking of external things, thinking of the sound that's in your heart, the sound that's in your head, getting it out through your hands straight to your guitar. So if you'd like to kind of have an assignment, something that you can do at home to work on this, what I would suggest is taking one of your favorite licks. It doesn't matter if it's a blues lick, a country lick, whatever it is, take one of your favorite licks and one of your favorite riffs and really dig into it and see how different you can make it just by adjusting with your hands, where you're picking, your vibrato, kind of the strength of your fretting hand and your picking hand, and also by using your volume and tone. So for instance, if I take a classic blues lick, right, or in the key of A minor, starting on the A string 7th fret, D string 5th, 7, we take that riff, right? I challenge you to see how many ways that you can play that riff and be creative just by adjusting what you're doing on the guitar or your volume and tone. So we could start here like... All right, here, I'll do some picking. And then move that riff around. Bend into it. All in all, just have fun with it and realize that there's a lot more that you have right here at your exposed that you're not using it. So keep messing with that. And guitar, thanks for having me. Jared James Nichols, Blues Power. I love you guys. Have a great time. Music is not a competition. Just have fun and play your guitars. See you soon.